Hi, everybody. Welcome to 190 North. We're going to start out rocking today. A powerhouse band that's been around for three decades, 22 gold albums. Well, I'm talking about the band Rush, and its lead singer, Geddy Lee, was recently in town, sat down, and spoke with our own Lou Kanellis.
Tom Sawyer. It's one of the biggest hits and probably the most recognizable song for Rush. But this Canadian group was cranking out music long before Tom Sawyer came along back in 1981. This power trio got its start in Toronto back in 1968 as a cover band. And they went on to much bigger things, though, like 22 gold albums.
Well, you know, it happened very slowly for us. We were never overnight sensations, and still in certain territories of the world we were considered a cult band.
So, what kept the guys who make up Rush together so long, you ask?
We enjoy each other as musicians, and we've never allowed a monetary or territorial issues to be divisive inside the band, and we have an incredibly loyal following that has always been interested in what we want to do. I think you put that combination together, and I guess that explains it kind of.
Despite the string of successes spanning three decades, the music making came to an end for the band in 1997 when tragedy struck drummer Neil Peart's family. In one year, he lost both his wife and daughter.
I don't mean to be so nihilistic.
The time apart brought a whole new chapter in bassist and lead singer Geddy Lee's career.
I was always very happy in the context of Rush and continue to be happy with my partnership. But I had a desire to work with a good friend of mine, Ben Mink. We've threatened each other with trying to write together for years, and it was time to find out if we could take our highly absurd friendship into the studio with us.
The product from that partnership, My Favorite Headache. It's the very first solo effort for Rush frontman Geddy Lee, and it hit store shelves just last month. Much of My Favorite Headache came out of sessions in Lee's recording studio in his Vancouver home.
How was the take? Was it great? I could try it with a Scottish accent. Is that better?
For Rush fans who've gone 3 years without a new release, Lee thinks this may help fill the void.
Certainly there are some crossover points, and there are some material on this record that would certainly be at home on a Rush album. But there are differences, such as the rhythmic attitude is much rounder.
And loyal Rush followers can be pretty sure their favorite band will be rocking again very soon.
Hopefully mid-January, beginning of February, we'll be out there in Canada writing some songs.
The band's label is hoping that reunion will lead to a new Rush album to hit stores this time next year. Until then, Geddy's busy promoting his solo career. No concert dates yet, but he's making plenty of appearances like this one at Rolling Stones Records on Irving Park Road.
And I've seen every show since 90.
After all these years, the fans keep coming. Even a new generation of Rush fans is emerging. He says that makes it all worth it.
You know, I see people that are in their 30s, in their 40s. There's a whole bunch of kids I met yesterday that were 11 years old, 12 years old, and, you know, teenagers. It's very gratifying.
Geddy Lee's CD, his first solo effort, is called My Favorite Headache. It is in stores now.